Welcome to the course on Emulation Software HT-IDE3000 Teaching. This chapter will take you to understand the basic teaching of the HT-IDE3000, which will be introduced from the following six topics. What will we learn in this course? Emulator eLink Pro 2 Introduction. Download and install the HT-IDE3000. How to create a new project. How to debug. And HT8 CodeConfig. What will we learn in this course? The MCU-IDE plays an important role in the embedded system development, providing many functions and tools to help developers create, debug, and deploy application programs more efficiently. Includes code writing. The IDE provides an integrated code editor which enables developers to write code for embedded application programs. The inclusion of syntax highlighting, code automatic completion, and other features improve coding efficiency and accuracy. Compile and generate executable files. The IDE includes an integrated compiler which can compile the written code into a target platform executable binary file. It also supports setting compiler options, optimization levels, and linker settings to generate the best code and executable files. Debugging and testing. The IDE provides debugging tools such as single step, breakpoint setting, variable monitoring, etc., to help developers debug and test embedded application programs. These tools allow developers to trace the execution of code, observe the values of variables, and find out potential errors and problems. Hardware programming and deployment. The IDE integrates a programming tool which allows developers to program their compiled code into the target hardware using a writer. This enables developers to run the application program directly on the target hardware and test its performance and functionality. Course topics. This course will introduce the Emulator eLink Pro 2. How to create a new project in the HT-IDE3000. How to debug, as well as introducing an additional tool. Emulator eLink Pro 2 Introduction. The eLink Pro 2 is a whole-tech debug adapter. Together with the HT-IDE3000, it can implement the MCU online emulation, debugging function, and also provides an ICP, onboard, programming function. Its design is compact and simple, easy to use and flexible, which can improve the efficiency of customer product development. The eLink Pro 2 uses Type-C USB port, equipped with USB-A to USB-C connector cable for connecting computer USB port. This USB meets the USB 2.0 full speed, 12 megabits per second, specification. If the eLink Pro 2 is used to power the target development board, ensure that the PC USB port has sufficient power supply capacity. According to the actual power supply capacity of the USB port, see the table, the eLink Pro 2 can only output a maximum current of about 400 mA. If the application needs greater current, an external power supply is required. The eLink Pro 2 hardware provides a simple LED display interface, which is for statue, error, and active respectively. When in use, the connection status with PC, electric vehicle emulation status and emulation, programming results can be observed via the LED. In addition, a key is also designed on the eLink Pro 2 to give different functions according to various applications, which can implement the eLink Pro 2 hardware reset or the one key programming function in the offline programming mode. The connection interface between eLink Pro 2 and emulation electric vehicle uses a 12-pin, 2x6 interface. The related pin function names are printed on the back rubber shell. When the emulation and debugging function is used, only 4 lines are required for connection, which are VDD, VSS, OCDSCK, and OCDSDA. A connection cable, 12-pin to 5-pin, has been equipped before delivery, which has a mistake-proof mechanism and contains pin labels for convenient connection. In addition to emulation and programming functions, the eLink Pro 2 can also download flash IC, EEPROM IC, USB, to I2C, SPI, UART, bridge, and other functions when being used with other whole-tech software. Download and install the HT-IDE3000. Next, explain how to download the HT-IDE3000. First, open a browser to the Holtec official website, www.holtec.com. Click MCU Tools to go to the MCU Tools page. Click ICE to go to the ICE page. Go to Support Software to find the HT-IDE3000 software and click it to download. The following explains how to install the HT-IDE3000. After downloading, decompress it first. Run the installer. Follow the installer instructions to install. Click Finish to complete the HT-IDE3000 installation. Next, introduce how to add an MCU. To add an MCU to the HT-IDE3000, first download the MCU update. The URL for downloading is the same as for downloading the HT-IDE3000. Go to https://www.holtec.com/ICE, click on MCU updated to download. After downloading, follow the installer instructions to install. That is how to add an MCU to the HT-IDE3000. How to create a new project. Developing an application program in the HT-IDE3000 starts with creating a project. A project includes the application program location and file name. See compiler version selection and compiler settings, optimization parameters and debug required settings and other settings. Next, demonstrate how to create a new project. Click on the project menu and select the new command to activate the wizard. On the first page, enter the project name and set the project path. Select an MCU. Users can search from the pull-down list box or directly enter the MCU name. Choose a C compiler. The default is to use the version 3 compiler, which provides an optimization function. Select the file type for the default output source file and the output file name. Set the MCU option. Then go to the project settings screen. Use the default settings and click OK to complete the project creation. Click New on the toolbar to start coding the program. After editing, there are three methods to add files to the project. Right-click on the editor, click Insert File into Project after a menu appears. Or select the Edit command in the project menu to choose the file to be added. If more than one file needs to be added at a time, press the Ctrl key. Use the mouse to select the desired files and click Add to Add. Or right-click on the workspace window. Click Add Files to Project after a menu appears. And select the files to be added. To change the project settings, select the Project Setting command in the Options menu. To change the compiler settings, click Build option. To change the editor settings, select the Editor Setting command in the Options menu. How to debug. This is the E-Link Pro 2-pin assignment. Only VDD, OCDSCK, OCDSDA, and GND need to be connected to the corresponding EV pins. The next is to explain how to debug. To debug, first build the project and then download the compiled program to the development board. Building a project can execute the build or build all command to compile. After the build all command is executed, all the files are recompiled, while the build command only compiles the currently modified file. When the build command has been executed, the compiled output message will be displayed on the output window. The program will be downloaded automatically after the compilation is completed. After the download is completed, if the text is highlighted in yellow, debugging can begin. The next is to explain how to start the hardware program. To start the hardware program, press F5 directly. Or click Go on the toolbar to start the hardware program. After starting, users can see that the stop button on the toolbar changes from gray to red. To stop the hardware, click the stop button on the toolbar. When it changes from red to gray, this indicates that the hardware has stopped. The next is to explain how to set and remove breakpoints. The HT8 OCDSEV can set up to 7 breakpoints. After setting breakpoints, the program will stop when it meets a breakpoint. At this time, we can observe whether the variable value is as expected in the watch window. A breakpoint can be set by clicking the program line to be set on the editor and then pressing F9, and this line will be highlighted in red, indicating that the breakpoint has been set successfully. Or click Insert, Remove Breakpoint on the toolbar. To remove a breakpoint, only press F9 on the line highlighted in red or click Insert, Remove Breakpoint on the toolbar. The red highlight will disappear, indicating that the breakpoint has been removed. To remove all breakpoints at a time, click Removes All Breakpoints on the toolbar. These are the instructions for setting, removing breakpoints. The next is to introduce single step. Single step is a debug technique, which is used to execute code step by step and observes its execution results. The IDE provides several single step commands, namely step into, step over, and step out. There are some differences between them. The step into command will enter the procedure and execute the code in the procedure line by line when it encounters a call procedure instruction. To use the HT-IDE3000 step into function, press F8. Or click Step Into on the toolbar. The step over command will execute the entire procedure without entering the procedure and jump to the next line after the procedure when it encounters a call procedure instruction. To use the HT-IDE3000 step over function, press F10. Or click Step Over on the toolbar. The step out command will complete the unexecuted part of the current procedure and return to the location of the previous call function. To use the HT-IDE3000 step out function, press Shift plus F7 or click Step Out on the toolbar to jump back to the location of the previous call function. That is the description for single step. Next, explain how to add variables and modify values in the watch window. The watch window is a very useful tool in the IDE to monitor and trace the values and states of variables during debugging. By adding specific variables to the watch window, users can observe their values in real time, which helps to understand the process and state of code execution. The HT-IDE3000 provides 4 watch windows for users to trace values. To add the variable value to the watch window, enter the variable directly in the watch window. Or drag the variable directly into the watch window. To modify the variable value, users can directly change the value field in the watch window and press Enter. That is the description for watch window about adding variables and modifying values. HT8 CodeConfig. The HT8 CodeConfig is an intuitive graphical user interface software which has the ability to configure the MCU hardware pins and automatically generate MCU initialization code. Integrated in the HT-IDE3000 Integrated Development Environment, IDE, and combined with the Holtec software library, it is a powerful and easy-to-use development tool. Using the HT8 CodeConfig can quick start project. The HT8 CodeConfig provides an intuitive software interface to help users set up the MCU peripherals and IC pin functions, and can generate the MCU peripheral driver code only using a mouse without spending a lot of time reading the datasheet to easily start project development. Simplify hardware pin configuration. The HT8 CodeConfig provides the MCU pin shared settings that simplify pin settings by using an intuitive software interface to arrange pin functions. Reduce product development cycle. In the past, Starting a new series of MCU development often required reading lengthy datasheet or other technical materials to understand the MCU peripheral settings. Now, using the HT8 CodeConfig graphical interface can plan and configure the peripherals and generate code associated with the software library, therefore greatly reducing the product development time. The HT8 CodeConfig operation flowchart is shown below. There are mainly 5 steps. 1. Set the MCU system frequency. 2. Select the peripherals required for the project. 3. Set parameters for the selected peripherals. 4. Set the MCU pin shared functions. 5. Execute generate IDE project to generate the initialization code, link the MCU software library, and finally produce HT-IDE 3000 project. Now begin the HT8 CodeConfig software interface navigation. The HT8 CodeConfig software settings are divided into 5 areas. This area is the MCU optional peripheral area. Here users can select the desired peripherals to add to the project. This area is the selected peripheral area. Here the selected peripherals have been added to the project. This area is the peripheral setting area. Users can set the peripherals in this area. This area is the MCU pin setting area. Changing the IC package can be implemented in this area. Click Generate IDE Project to generate the HT-IDE 3000 project for subsequent development. How to create a new HT8 CodeConfig project. Method 1. Start the HT8 CodeConfig directly. Click New Project, enter the project name, select an MCU and click the New Project button. Method 2. Create a new project from the HT-IDE 3000. Select an MCU when creating a new project from the HT-IDE 3000. If the selected MCU supports the HT8 CodeConfig, check the CodeConfig option and click Next to start the HT8 CodeConfig. Next, explain how to add peripherals to the HT8 CodeConfig project. Users can directly click the peripheral to be added in the MCU optional peripheral area. Take the addition of the SIM as an example. In this area, users can set the parameters for the selected peripherals. After the peripherals are added, the corresponding function pins will be automatically configured. The red text on a blue background is used to highlight the configurable pins which belong to this peripheral. Users can click it to configure the pin. The options marked with a bottom line indicate that they must be configured. Next, explain how to switch the peripheral settings. Click on the peripheral to be set directly in the added peripheral area to complete the switching. The next is to explain how to remove the peripheral. To remove the added peripheral, click the X icon next to the peripheral to be removed. Next, introduce pin configuration and conflict resolution. Assume that the SIM pin configuration is as shown in the figure. After adding the comparator. The comparator must be configured with CX, C+, and C-. At this point we find that only C+ is configured, but what about CX, C-? You can find 2 warning signs. Moving the mouse to the warning signs and holding for a while will display a message indicating that the CX cannot be configured because it has been configured by the SDI. To resolve the CX configuration conflict, users can change the SDI configuration. Then set the CX again, the CX warning sign will disappear. However, the C- is not so lucky, because there is no other SCSB or C- pins resulting in no configuration. In this case, only the MCU package can be changed. For example, we choose 28QFN. There are other SCSB pins that can be configured. After changing the SCSB configuration and then configuring the C-, you can see that the C- warning sign disappears. These are the instructions for pin configuration and conflict resolution.